In this edition of Art Loft, deadly nature becomes beautiful art. A photographer shows us that the past is only an arm's length away.
Everyone thinks that we knock everything down and put it back up, but you know, a lot of the rich, rich history is still standing.
An animated look at alienation. A mural stands as testament to the history of the Florida Keys.
Years from now, if I'm living here or if I come back to visit, I have my grandchildren and like, I painted that.
And Brazilian folktales told through dance.
I'm a very fast and like bound dancer, so I'm like, ga, 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 ga.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation, Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years, Alva H. and Wyline P. Chapman Foundation, and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show, and every day is another masterpiece.
Hi, I'm Kalyn James, and from the studio of artist Oliver Sanchez and home to Swampspace in Miami, this is Art Loft. This week, our stories focus on isolation and history with a side order of natural science. But first up, we turn to dance. Inspired by Mary Joan Gerson's book, How Night Came from the Sea, brass dance choreographer Augusto Soledage uses contrasting movements to narrate this Afro-Brazilian folktale. And in a different creative piece, Soledage reflects on marginalization and social tension via a contemporary dance performance. We caught up with the artist and his dancers during their rehearsals at the African Heritage Cultural Arts Center in Miami. Take a look.
I like the beauty in movement. I started dancing when I was little, but mainly social dances, dances in Brazil like samba and forró, which is a partnering kind of dance that we do. And then later on, when I started to become more interested in getting formal training, I started to do ballet, modern dance, contemporary dance, jazz, and other forms. I was interested in blending all these different forms because I felt that way I could get to a style that is my own as opposed to just reproducing something that I've just learned. Breast dance is really a blend of many different dance idioms. My background is Afro-Brazilian. And the two works that we just recently performed, one is called Kayala, the other one is called Cordel. For Kayala, I use literature as the main inspiration. I got to know about the story of how night came from the sea, which is a reinterpretation of a Brazilian folktale.
The beginning starts very high energy. And then I'm missing the darkness and that life that I know.
The night sections of the work are a little more mellow and they reach out into space a little bit more. They're a little softer in the performance. And the day is very upbeat.
You know, your blood is pumping from all the rhythms and the drums, and you're moving your hips and you're jumping and you're throwing your leg in the air and then you're turning and your head's going with you, and it's just exciting. Going from this high energy movement to then finding that still strong, but sort of calmness so that my body can still flow and, you know, my head keeps going with the movement, but I'm still very centered and I'm not just like wobbling all over the place.
I'm a very fast and like bound dancer, so I'm like ga, 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 you know, I want to be all over the place. And cordel, I have to really lengthen my limbs. I'm a small, petite dancer. So make myself look long and move through the movement.
And we're sort of like weaving through each other in all these different patterns. And we repeat the patterns, but in different ways.
You see movement that happens, you know, here a certain way, and then that same movement gets repeated here. And there's something else in between the repetition of something that got identified at first. They really try to navigate through the negative space of one another. I connect that level of interaction with capoeira, which is considered the Brazilian martial art. And in that game, you don't hit your opponent. You basically indicate to the opponent where his or her weakness spot is, you know? And so I felt that had a lot to do with tango and how the interaction got established. You know, it's not so much about determining a winner, but it's about understanding how complex relationship and interaction can really be.
Augusto Soladagi Brass Dance offers master classes to advanced level dancers. If you'd like to learn more or attend an upcoming performance, visit brassdance.com.
And you know, I think every 15 minutes or every half hour, the church bells still ring. And so two blocks away at the Houston Press Building, you hear that all day long. I mean, sometimes I'll take a picture and it takes me 15 minutes just to get the shot.
Our next story takes us to mile marker 95 in the Florida Keys near Key Largo, where a community came together to create a work of art that also commemorates a historic milestone.
Visitors and residents traveling the Florida Keys Overseas Highway have a new outdoor art mural to view at mile marker 95 Bayside in Key Largo.
This mural honors the 100th anniversary of the completion of Henry Flagler's Florida Keys Overseas Railroad.
The hand-painted mural, measuring 60 feet long and 11 and a half feet high, depicts a train similar to a Florida Keys Overseas Railroad passenger train steaming across an arched bridge, much like the Long Key Viaduct. Above the bridge is a full moon adorned with the face of the railroad's creator, Henry Flagler.
The inspiration for this painting was an image that was like a 3x5 postcard, and the problem was it's over three times as long proportionately as the original. So, of course, the whole thing had to be rethought out and designed.
That looks very, very good, Bailey.
The mural was a collaborative effort between the Art Guild of the Purple Isles and high school art club students at Isla Mirada's Island Christian School.
These are all people that work in the community and that I'll see in the community. And it's gonna be really great years from now, if I'm living here or if I come back to visit, I have my grandchildren and like, I painted this. It's gonna be here for a while. And it's a part of history.
The mural joins a variety of outdoor art in the Florida Keys, ranging from murals of the region's abundant marine life, including several by world-renowned artist Wyland, to offbeat roadside creation, such as the supersized replica lobster that greets visitors at the artisan's village at Isla Mirada's Rain Barrel.
Painting this with a historical element makes it a lot more special because I'm living in the product of the railroad.
If you'd like to find out more about the Flagler Overseas Railroad mural or any other public art in the Florida Keys, visit their website at fla-keys.com. Photographer Abraham Garza spends his lunch hours roaming the streets of downtown Houston, finding the locations of old postcards and creating new images that blend the historical with the modern. His photographs remind us that history is often hiding in plain sight.
Houston Press, how may I do what you call?
I'm actually the receptionist at the Houston Press. I've worked there since 1999. I started collecting postcards, you know, in early, maybe 2000, 2001. And the idea of going out to shoot them with their current locations just fascinated me. First photo montage I did was a photograph of being my mother. were standing in front of our house in South Houston. She passed away 3 years ago, so it was very sentimental to take this shot, and it's really what catapulted this entire project. When I found the picture of our own building, you know, the entire office was buzzing because nobody really knew what it was before. So this is the Houston Press building. This picture is from 1965. You can see the Exxon building behind it. It was built in 1963, so it's relatively new at the time. And it used to be a Gilman Pontiac car dealership. And now this is where I work. You know, Bonnevilles used to be sold right out of my office. A lot of times what works with the photo is lining up the existing architecture. If I have a photo and it has a window or an awning, I try to line it up right. It's all about patience. The First Methodist United Church has been around since the 30s. And every 15 minutes or every half hour, the church bells still ring. And so two blocks away at the Houston Press Building, you hear that all day long. I mean, sometimes I'll take a picture and it takes me 15 minutes just to get the shot. Whenever there's a photo with people, you definitely get the date around when it was. You know, people are in suits, people are in dresses, you know, it's totally different. This was taken on Main Street outside of the Rice Hotel in, I believe, 1965. You got the old defunct Houston Press, which is back then was a daily paper, cafeteria, coffee house, and Main Street. I would say I've become obsessed with it. There will be a day where I'll come across a photograph and I need to take it as soon as I can. All right, this is Jones Hall. It won an award in 1967, the year it was built. Jones Hall itself is literally unchanged, and the Gulf building behind it has a 45-foot sign that could be seen from all over Houston. The original picture was taken in 1952, and I mean, there are no skyscrapers in downtown, you know. For a minute, the tallest building we had was City Hall, and that one's, it's visible in the photo. And I guess in 1952, they thought it was okay to not have a fence to protect the people walking over the bridge. And as you can see, it's also existing construction. It's the exact same, the exact pillars, everything. Caught in place, just minutes from downtown. This one's a little tricky, but luckily I have long arms. It's a private community, virtually unchanged since the day this photo was taken. Houston is developing in a way where everyone thinks that we knock everything down and put it back up, but you know, a lot of the rich, rich history is still standing. You just have to look for it.
You can see a lot more of Abrahan Garza's photo montages at historicproject.com. Coral morphologic is a scientific art endeavor led by marine biologist Colin Ford and musician Jared McKay. With their aquarium as the primary medium, they explore the artistic possibilities of living coral reef organisms through HD videography and site-specific artworks. Their film, Man of War, premiered at the Borscht Film Festival in April 2011.
Thank you.
Find out more about Coral Morphologic on their website at coralmorphologic.com, and you can view the film and other Borscht Film Festival entries at the festival site, borschtcorp.com.
When women are underwater, they're comfortable, but when they reach the surface, they have to deal with a whole new level of reality.
Before we say goodbye tonight, we have one more story from our friends at MIA Animation, a film called Fisher. Fisher was directed by Yoram Benz. Benz, who now lives in Miami, is originally from Hawaii and spent many years working at studios in New York and LA. Fisher is an intricate and stylized peek into the world of a lonely fisherman. It's been described as a cross between David Lynch and the incredible Mr. Limpet.
Thank you.
You can learn more about Yoram Benz at his website, oneeyedrobot.com. And remember, this year's MIA Animation Conference and Festival will take place on October 19th and 20th and will once again feature a pitch to the industry, animation wars, and an animation festival. Registration is already opened and they are accepting submissions for their competition. If you're an aspiring animator or even a seasoned pro, visit the website for more information, miaanimation.com. That's it for this week. I'm Kalyn James reminding you to stay creative, and thanks for watching Art Loft. Oh wait, the air. And it feels so good and looking like a million-dollar trooper. So this is your exercise? Swinging. Ah, I like your kind of fun. Swinging. No yelling. Remember I used to yell? Abraham Garza! Man of War premiered at the Borscht Film Festival in April 20th. Come back, boys! That's weird.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation. Newman's Own, giving all profit to charity and pursuing the common good for over 30 years. Alva H. and Wyline P. Chapman Foundation. And
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.